Okay, so what we have here is our optical fibre. I've said this is from last day. We put the angles always bigger than 42 degrees, and I wanted to draw down one, the wrong one, to say that this was wrong because it's too tightly packed together. The light doesn't bounce up and down optical fibre like that. It bounces with large angles. And that means it's got to stay above 42 degrees. I want you to do it where it's wrong, where it's not bouncing at 42 degrees. So do a second one where it's wrong. Okay, it's bouncing too much. You would get marks down for that in the exam. Also, you need to make sure you use a ruler in the exam or you'd lose a mark for that as well. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to do a little table now with the advantages and disadvantages of fibre optic cables. Okay, so I want you to put down... fibre optic cables.
I'll just do that in a bit better writing.
Fibre optic cables. So fibre optics versus copper cable. And I want cable with a T. How do I get cable with a T in it? Cable.
I've got a thing about putting T's and L's, like name them in it, I don't know why.
Advantages of fibre optics and disadvantages. Okay, I'm just going to write a couple of things on either side. Okay, so advantages and disadvantages. Advantages are, they're smaller, they're lighter, they're not affected by interference, for example from magnets or electromagnetic interference caused by anything electrical. They carry more information. There's not as many repeater stations required or booster stations required, and it's hard to tap into them. Disadvantages are they are slower than copper cable. Not much though, but they're slower. It doesn't mean, however, that they don't charge. They do send more information, so that's why they're better, but they are slower. And it's hard to repair the damage to a fibre optic cable. If somebody cuts it, it's hard to get it back together again. It's not impossible, it's just harder than it would be if it was a copper cable. Now, in the exam, I want you to think about, I want you to try and remember more so than any, a couple of these. I want you to remember that it is slower. So put a big star beside this one. Remember it's slower. Remember that it won't travel as fast in fibre optic cables. Big mistake is that it always travels faster in fibre optics, which is not the case. I also want you to remember this one here. More information, that's a big one. A big advantage is it's more information. I don't want you to mention cost at any time. So, do not mention cost unless asked. If you mention cost, it starts getting a bit confusing. Because at the end of the day, yes, it may be cheaper to make fibre optic cable, or it may be cheaper to make copper cable, who knows? But the bottom line is you're going to use a lot more fibre optics to replace one copper cable. Or the other way around, you're going to need a lot more copper cables to replace fibre optics. And really nowadays it's kind of hard to say which one's cheaper. I don't know. Probably the cost of producing fibre optics is so cheap now it doesn't make any difference. Okay? So do not mention cost unless asked. What other ones are important? Smaller, lighter, not affected by interference, more information. Not as many repeater stations. Put that one in as well. That's quite a handy one. You don't need to boost the signal very often. The light itself doesn't lose its signal quality as much as a copper cable does. So a copper cable will need lots of repeater stations to boost that signal up to case it if it's going over long distances. Okay? So there are our advantages and disadvantages. Okay.